So let's do the signs of the times. So listen to what our voice might be saying to us. So that we pause our attention to something that we can, you know, make a transformation, make some kind of change or adjustment in the way we conduct our affairs. And I think that is what the conference has been doing over the years, you know, raising the issues and reminding us that prayer is a way of life, and that when we worship God, it brings us into communion with God, it brings us into that relationship, and it also tells us that no matter what the issues might be in our lives, in our country, in our world, no matter how things might look dark and grim, there is always hope. Because when we praise God, when we sing God's praises, we actually pray, we cry out to Him, and we give our all to Him. We say, Lord, you come in, it is this situation. We would not allow the situation to keep us down. When we praise you, we lift our eyes and our voices, we lift our hands heavenwards. We are saying to ourselves and we are saying to the world that our situations cannot get the better of us. You know, that God is there for us. And though at times it seems as if our faith might be waning, it seems as if, you know, the difficulties can be insurmountable. Whenever we lift our voices in praise, then it is included in that, I believe, a tinge of hope for us, that we know that all is not lost, that we have an appeal authority, so to speak, whom we can call God, in whom, you know, we can find strength, because He gives us His strength daily, His divine strength, to be able to rise above the difficulties and the challenges that we face and that we have to face on a daily basis.